Hi, I'm Juliana Burfield at the Zakim Center for Integrative Therapies and Healthy Living at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. I'm here to guide you to a gentle yoga praxis today. It's going to be a flow class. Again, if you feel like you want to modify anything, please do. You can always go at your own range of motion, just honoring your body where it is today. We're going to use a couple of props for that. We're going to use some blocks. If you have a strap, you can use a strap if that's helpful for you. Make sure you have your mat. And again, don't forget to hydrate whenever you need to grab some water or anything else. Please do. Let's get started. We're going to come down to our mat. I'm having one block under my shoulder blades, the other one under my head. This is going to give me a nice support to release that tension and stress that we hold on to. Most likely, we're over some kind of screen of some sort. Your computer, your phone, you're always arching it. So this is going to right away allow you to pull those shoulders back, relax it down with the support so you can let go a little bit more. So finding that support of the block, bring it under your shoulder blades, and then taking the other block right under your head, maybe finding a little bit more support here. Pull your chin into your chest so you can feel this lengthening through the back of the neck and skull, and then allowing your arms to open to the side. And just by holding in this position, again, you're going to help you to open into the stress, let it go, but also getting rid of all that emotional stress that we carry in our chest. This is going to help you out too. I'm bringing the soles of the feet together and knees out to the side in Supta Baddha Konasana. Again, if this feels too much for you, you can bring the feet to the floor and let your knees knock in. Allowing yourself to rest here. And just starting to feel the support. We're going to do three cleansing breaths, inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the mouth. Take a nice deep breath in and a big sigh, let it go. Inhale and exhale. Last one, big inhale and let it go. Letting go of all the tension and stress, the drama, let it melt away. It's comfortable for you to close your eyes. Allow your eyes to close. And by closing the eyes, we can start to draw the awareness inwards, one of the eight limbs of yoga, pratyahara. And starting to feel your body releasing, feeling the heaviness of your bones grounding, being supported by the earth. And when we connect with the earth, we find a sense of well-being, of safety, also with anxiety, stress. And as you feel the body supported, the hips, the shoulder blades, the back of the skull, you can let go a little bit more. So the muscles in the face starting to soften, you relax the cheeks, the jaw, softening the tongue, down the shoulders, the arms, fingers, hips, legs, toes. And as you find your body fully supported, relaxed and safe, start to deepen the awareness to your breath. The inhaling, expanding and rising. And as you exhale, starting to notice the softening, the release, the letting go. As the breath moves in, and as the breath moves out. If you know your jaya breath, that whispering, hissing breath, you can start it at any time. It feels like you're narrowing the back of the throat, like if you're fogging a mirror, but the mouth is closed, making that sound. If this bothers your throat, just breathe normally. Making the sound, the breath audible. Sounding like waves crashing on the shore as it moves in and as it moves out. And now starting to notice that pauses between the inhalation and the exhalation. and perhaps noticing that the breath is getting longer, deeper, smoother. And that the mind starts to calm down, quiet down. So by drawing the awareness to the breath, it's a great way to calm the mind, quiet the thoughts. And that's what yoga is all about, calming the chattering mind. Our mind is always thinking, planning, doing, redoing. But if we can find a little bit more peace, if we can find that pause between the thoughts, we can actually listen. We can tender to our heart. And then from there, we can act better, react better, feel better. So we're coming back to this breath awareness whenever you need to find quiet and peace, not only here on your mat, but in your daily life. With your next inhale, let your hands come into Anjali Mudra, prayer pose, palms together. Let the thumbs rest on your forehead. As you inhale, breathe in kind thoughts and positive energy. Let that fill you up. And as you exhale, let go of things that don't suit you. Create space for new and positive things to come. Finding this balance inside you. And adding your hands to your heart, one over the other. And just breathe in the gratitude of being here today. Taking time to honor your body. Or anything else that you're grateful for. Let it fill you up. As you exhale, release, let it go. Let the soles of the feet come to the floor. Knees up to the sky. We're gonna start to open our chest. You're gonna go at your own range of motion, wherever it is. Inhale, start to reach your arms up. As you exhale, soften your elbows, bend, reach it out to the side and down to the feet, circling those arms. We're gonna do two more, inhaling, reaching up, lifting up. Exhale, softening, releasing back. Last time through, inhale, reach up, lift up. Exhale, reaching back and out to the sides, let the elbows release, let the backs of your hands find the support. Breathe into your heart, into these cactus arms, and with your next exhale, let the elbows come parallel. Inhale, open. And with your next exhale, coming parallel, you're gonna let your right arm cross under the left, holding onto your shoulders, feeling like you're pulling a tight t-shirt. You're gonna come into Garudasana arms, eagle arms, staying with the hands on the shoulders or the backs of the hands or even the front. As you inhale, feel your arms reaching back. As you exhale, feel your elbows coming in, pull belly in, pull your chin into your chest and do a gentle curling in, starting to engage the core. Inhale, coming down and release. Exhale, soften. Take a nice deep breath into your heart. Exhale, closing it up, and this time the left arm comes under the right. So the shoulders, holding onto the shoulders, the elbows are stacked and they start to reach up. Maybe this is where you stay, maybe the backs of the hands or even the front. The inhale might take your hands slightly back. And the exhale, you start to pull your elbows in, navel in. You start to pull the chin into the chest, you start to curl slightly up. Inhaling, releasing it back. Exhale, softening it out. Take a nice deep breath in. And with your next exhale, closing your palms together, bring your hands behind the head. And when you do so, you're gonna take that block out of the way and letting your hands support your head like you're holding a little on a hammock here. Elbows are pointing straight up and you start to reach your elbows up one at a time. Start to get a little bit more stretch to the side body, to the shoulder blades. We're gonna start to engage our core a little bit more. With your next exhale, pull belly in, take your elbows up. And then inhale, bring it down. Exhale, perhaps you take one knee off the floor. You might even add a twist and inhale down. Exhale up and inhale down. We're gonna do that two more times. Exhale, twisting, inhaling down. Last time through, exhale, twist, inhale down. Holding it here, taking your hands along the side, we're gonna roll up, pull the navel in, feel the chest lifting, beautiful work. I'm gonna take the block out of the way and I'm gonna come back down to my elbows. A little bit more core work here. So having the hands down, feet on the floor, as you exhale, bring your knees in. Inhale, reaching it out. Exhale, take your knees to one side. Inhale, extend. exhale, take it to the other side. So staying on your elbows if your lower back tends to bother you. Otherwise, bringing yourself up into a seat. Feet can stay on the floor, or maybe you even take your feet up. And we're going to find this half boat. Again, think about like turbulent water. Maybe this is what you're feeling right now. I have some water right behind me. So again, if it gets a little shaky, that's okay. Exhale, twist. Inhale, coming down, half boat. Exhale, twist. Inhale, coming halfway down. Exhale, bring it up and cross through your knees and ankles. Nicely done. I'm going to take my hands behind, bring the feet down to the earth. Now as you push into your feet, come into a reverse tabletop. Just letting the hips reach up, reaching back, and then slowly bring it down. And from here, keeping the feet on the floor, we're going to add one more twist. So take your fingers perhaps behind you. You can turn them back or slightly in. In will feel a little nicer on your shoulders. Roll the shoulders up and back. Inhale, open the heart. Now squeeze your elbows, feeling like there's a little string attached to your sternum, pulling it up. Chest is expanding. Elbows squeezing. Now with your next exhale, drop your knees to the right and perhaps look over your left shoulder. Let that left shoulder open back. Nice gaze. Come back to the center. Adjust. Press into your feet, inhale, lift up. And now as you exhale, drop your knees to the left and roll your right shoulder back, look over. Nicely done. Come back to the center. And from here, we're gonna release. Come up into your seat. So again, you can bring a blanket or a block under your sit bones, whatever works here for you. Hands on the thighs, roll your shoulders up. And exhale, down the back. Take your peace fingers. This is actually a grounding mudra, and let it root down into the earth. So it's a really nice way to connect. And maybe take a nice deep breath in. You can even close your eyes here. If you can imagine all the tension and stress just washing away down your shoulders and your arms, disappearing into the earth. And with the inhale, feel all that positive energy lifting you up into your heart, shining. And as you exhale, bow your head to your heart once again. Roll your left ear to your left shoulder. Exhale, roll your chin into your chest. Inhale, roll the right ear to the right shoulder. And exhale, chin into the chest. Inhale, roll it over to the left. We're gonna stay here a little bit longer, just playing with the angle of the head, drop it down. So we're all built differently. We all do different things, but we all have this tendency of carrying a lot of tension and stress in our neck and shoulders. So take your time to explore, to be playful, to move it around. You can even take your fingertips a little further away and noticing the sensation. With your next exhale, roll your chin into your chest. And we're gonna take the right ear to the right shoulder. As you inhale, perhaps you take your fingertips a little further out, play with the angle of the head, exploring. So you always have a choice. You always can explore and do different variations of the pose. Letting go of things that don't suit you. As you exhale, roll your chin into your chest. And as you inhale, we're gonna take both arms up, lift up, reach up. And then doing this little side to side reach, getting a little taller, longer through the side body. Opening through the side. Inhale, reach up. And as we exhale, we're gonna twist to the left. Find the support onto the knee and the other one behind you. As you inhale, lift to the crown of the head. As you exhale, soften the belly and the shoulders, and perhaps you go a little deeper with your twist. Again, think about the inhale to lengthen, to lift, and the exhale to soften into that shoulders and chest and maybe go a little deeper. You're gonna keep your right hand where it is. The left hand behind you is gonna inhale, reach up, lift up, and you're coming into a side bend. Now connect through the sit bones. Connect through the side. And now if this bothers you, you can always take that arm behind the head or along the side. We're gonna slowly come back up. Let your right cross under and hold. Just like we did in the beginning, coming into those Garudasana arms, eagle arms. Inhale, reaching up. Perhaps the backs of the hands or the front. Take a nice deep breath in. As you exhale, twist. You look over one shoulder. Elbow goes to the opposite. Inhale. And exhale to the other side. Inhale, come back to the center. Lift up, reach up. Exhale, you're gonna start to bring your elbows in. Unwind your hands and slowly leaning forward. Tent the fingers. Wherever you are is just perfect. Feel the lift in the spine. As you exhale, you fold. Soften the upper body, relax the shoulders, the head. Now, if you feel, you can always add a little movement here, side to side, if that feels good. If the knees cross bothers, you can always have your legs extended. With your next exhale, walk your hands back in. Roll your shoulders up and back. Take your hands behind you. We're going to switch the cross of the legs wherever one was in front switches. Again, sitting up nice and tall. Find your ground. Find your seat. As you inhale, reach up, lift up. And as we exhale, we're going to twist this time to the right. Find the support of the hands and behind you. Inhale, lift. Now as you exhale, start to soften the belly and the shoulder starts to go back. Again, inhale, lengthen. And as you exhale, slowly soften, and perhaps you go a little further back. Keeping the left hand where it is, the right hand is going to reach up, inhale, lift up. Exhale, you start to side bend. Maybe this is where you stay, maybe the hand behind the head, or even along the side of the body. Find the opening that works for you. Connecting with the sit bones, don't let them move. Inhale, come back to the center. And this time you're going to let the left cross under. Maybe you're holding onto your shoulders, or maybe the backs of the hands, or even the front. You're finding your eagle arms. Inhale, reach up, lift up. Now as you exhale, twist. You look over to one side, elbows go to the other. Come back to the center and twist to the other side. Inhale, come back to the center, lift up, reach up. Exhale, bring your elbows into your belly, unwind your arms, fingertips come down to the earth. Soften the head, relax the body, just breathe. Noticing the softness into the back, the shoulders, relaxing the jaw, wherever you are is just perfect. And then from here, we're gonna slowly come back up. Extending the legs, maybe it feels like good to give it a little shake. We're gonna move into a tabletop position. So bringing your hands to the mat. Again, if you feel like you need padding for your knees, always you can always use a blanket under your knees or under your mat. Fingers are facing forward, hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. And we're gonna start to move into a cat by pushing the floor away and broadening into the back, dropping that tail of your cat, navels engage. And as you inhale, feel the opening of your heart and the gate of your arms into your cow chest. The tail might go up. Now again, if you have a little bit lower back issues, keep it a little bit more neutral with the core engaged a little bit more. So let's do that together. Exhale, push down to lift up, relax the head. Inhale, open the heart. Exhale, rounding the spine. Inhale, open. Now again, start to add a little bit more here. So start to play with this. Perhaps you start to circle it around, letting the head be soft. Maybe you're moving it back and forth or even side to side. Whatever works for you. I like the circle movement. I think it gets a little bit more softness and ease in my neck and shoulders. So again, exploring this, whatever you need to do. And we're coming back into a tabletop in a breath or two. So take your time, find your way there. So from here, we're gonna come into a spinal balance. So slide your right foot back. Walk your left fingertips forward, and when you're ready, inhale, pick up your left arm. Arm is closer to the ear, right leg is reaching back, nice and strong. As you exhale, take your elbows and knees together. Now, if you want to add a little bit more of a challenge, inhale, find that length, and with the exhale, take the elbow to the side, the knee to the side. So this is going to challenge your balance. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, under or side, your choice. Take one more inhale. And this time as you exhale, we're gonna drop the left hand down. We're gonna take the right foot out to the side and you're gonna move your hips back and forth. So now you're starting to get a little bit more movement into the inner legs. You should feel this into your groins here. And we're gonna take it a little bit more. So next time we come forward, we're gonna hold it here. Walk your right hand maybe an inch or two forward. Inhale, left hand behind the ear, elbow goes down. Take it up as you inhale. Exhale, drop it down. We're gonna take this, maybe the arm up, reach up, lift up, exhale, thread the needle, slide your left shoulder under. It's like your left fingertips are gonna try to find your right toes. The right hand can stay closer to your head for support. Some of you might even fancy and take that arm up or even wrap it behind the back. So find what works here for you. Feel a stretch twisting into that upper back. And as you exhale, bring that hand down. So twists are really good. They're energizing. They give you a little bit more of a lift, help with the circulation, digestion, and the immune system. Take the right leg up and over. Make a little C with your spine. You look over your left shoulder. And as you exhale, we're going to bring that knee back in. Inhale. push and looking forward. Exhale, round the spine. So now you come into your tabletop again, and we're gonna take it to the other side. Left toes right back, right fingertips reach forward. Pick up that arm closer to the ear, left leg reaches back. So find the length from the fingertips to the toes. Exhale, elbows and knees. Inhale, reach again. Maybe taking that challenge of taking the elbow to the side, the knee to the side, keep it high. Inhale, reach. Exhale, bend. As you inhale, you reach and hold. And now from here, as you exhale, slowly take it to the side, bring that hand down, left leg goes out. We're gonna take that right elbow down, inhale, open it up. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, open it up, and perhaps reach it up, lift it up. And as you exhale, thread the needle. Can you slide that right shoulder under? And again, if this bothers, you can also put a block or a blanket under the head. Feel that reach. Left hand can stay close by, it can go up, it can even wrap behind the back. So find a little bit more opening and rotation into that shoulder if you can. With your next exhale, we're gonna bring that left hand down. It's gonna support you. Slide that arm from under and take your left foot all the way to the right. You're making a little C with your spine. You look over your right shoulder, breathe in. And exhale, bring it back in. Inhaling, looking forward. Exhale, rounding the spine as you wiggle your hips back to your heels. You start to find your child's pose. Sitting back onto your heels. And if you need any padding, again, between the shins and the tail, you can always add that. The weight of the hips down connects you to the earth once again. That support under your forehead is really grounding. Take a nice breath here. And with your next exhale, walk your hands over to the left. Let the right hand come on top of the left hand. Breathe into the right side. Flare those ribs with the breath. Slowly transition back to the center. Take it to the other side. Left hand on top of the right. Inhale, breathe into the left side. Flare those ribs. Come back to the center. And from here, let your hands pull you forward and up. Start to transition to your tucking the toes and pedaling the feet. We're coming into a down dog. We're not gonna stay here very long, but just feeling the sensation of the feet, the hands. As we inhale, we come into a plank. Hold it here. Your hands are gonna be right under your shoulders, knees, heels pushing back, core is nice and engaged. And then from here, drop down to your knees. Let your elbows brush in and slowly come all the way down to the earth. Let the hands be closer to your body, roll the shoulders. So your chin is down, it's the shoulders rolling up and back, the elbows squeezing, those outer ankles firming in, that helps you to lift into your heart. And then soften and release. Perhaps you tent the fingers along the side of the mat and modify cobra, maybe coming a little bit higher, rolling those shoulders, squeezing the elbows, opening the heart. And exhale, soften and release. Let your elbows come right in front of you. Feel the elbows digging in, pulling the chest forward and through. So from your shoulders to your elbows to your wrists, there's a straight line, like a number 11, pulling it in. The elbows might be an inch or two forward, and you feel this opening your heart. This is a great place to relax the head and soften the jaw. Again, you can do up dog, you can do low cobra or sphinx, wherever one works for you. With your next exhale, soften and release. We're gonna transition back from that tabletop to the down dog. And we're gonna take the right leg up, bending the knee, opening the hips. Maybe staying here and stepping the right foot to the right thumb. Drop your left knee down. Finding your blocks here for you. If you need the blocks, you can always use blocks or just the fingertips on the floor. Inhale, let your arms reach up, lift up, open up. Maybe gazing up, beautiful. Exhale, fold. And as you do, press your right heel, push your right hip back, and let your upper body fold. Inhaling, reaching up, lifting up. And exhale, softening, releasing, and letting go. This is your last one. We're gonna reach up, lift up. And from here, we're gonna come back and we're gonna fine tune this pose a little bit more. Think about your right heel pushing back and your left knee reaching forward. So your legs are almost like scissoring up, core starts to engage, chest starts to lift. And as you inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, finding your cactus arms. And from here, we're gonna twist. So we're gonna twist to the right. We can open the arms or you can keep that right hand behind the head. Let the left hand drop to the sky, the floor. Inhale, right elbow goes up. Exhale, right elbow drops down. Inhale, right elbow or arm reaches up. Exhale, hand comes down. And you can stay with the hand down. You can even take the back foot off, back knee off the floor, and just to make this a little bit more intense. Knee on the floor or not, right? You feel that your hands are pulling your chest forward, maybe adding a little bit of movement. Support onto your hands, step your right foot back. So you're coming back into that plank. Drop to your knee, brush your elbows into your ribs, come all the way down to the earth. Point the toes and finding your low cobra or your sphinx, opening your heart. And as you exhale, soften and release, transition back again from that tabletop, perhaps tucking the toes and finding a down dog. You can also stay onto your tabletop to step your foot forward. It doesn't have to go into a down dog. Step it forward, drop the knee in, and when you're ready, inhale, let your arms go up. Again, you can always use blocks under your hands. Exhale, push your left hip back, heel down to the floor, and you're gonna feel the stretch on under the knees. Inhaling, opening the front line of the body, right hip flexors, chest open up, maybe gazing to the sky, it's beautiful here. Exhale, press the heel, push it back, soften. Last time through, you're gonna inhale, come up. And as we exhale, we're gonna bring ourselves back. Again, just getting a little deeper into those right hip flexors. Again, if you think about the legs scissoring, pulling together, the core starts to engage. You get a deeper sensation into your right hip flexor. Staying here, maybe adding those arms, maybe taking into the cactus. As you exhale, we're gonna twist, engage a little bit more the core. And from here, keeping the left hand behind the head or fully extended, right hand comes down. Drop that elbow down. Inhale, open. Exhale, bring it back down. Perhaps you extend the arm, inhale, open. Exhale, all the way down. It's gonna come on the inside of the foot. You can even shimmy your left foot a little bit more forward and out. And you start to move your hips. Maybe you take that back knee off the floor. So again, you can stay with the knee on the floor or off. It's whatever works here better for you. You start to move it. And with your next exhale, we're gonna step that left foot back. Finding your plank once again. Knees can drop to the floor. And some of you might even try chaturanga, coming down, controlling. I know this is a harder one to do. Dropping it down, and again, finding your low cobra, your modified cobra, or your sphinx. As you exhale, push it back. Transition through that child's pose to a down dog. And we're gonna walk our hands back to the feet. So you're gonna take your time, soften your knees a lot, and let your forearms be supported on your thighs. And just doing a little assessing here how the backs of the legs, the body feels, relaxing the legs and shoulders. So for some, keeping the spine a little bit more long and up might feel better. If you don't have any lower back issues, you can let the head maybe drop. Again, this can always be bent into the knee, let the body relax. And with your next exhale, perhaps you start to roll your body up. Take your time, navel pulls in, shoulders roll back. Inhale, let your arms reach up, lift up. Big inhale and exhale, hands to the heart. Great job. So now that we're up, we're gonna do some standing flows. Just again, maybe perhaps having those blocks close by to the front edge of your mat. Now start to connect here with your heels, dropping through the tail. And when you're ready, inhale, reach your arms up, get long and strong. And as you exhale, hinging from your hips. Again, hands can stay on the shins, can stay on the blocks. If you have the blocks, support the hands on the blocks and step your left foot back. Left heel down to the floor. Bring your hands to your thighs and bring yourself up. From here, inhale, reach up. Exhale, open your left arm back behind you. Perhaps you walk that foot a little further back. You want to make sure that your right knee and ankle and toes are aligned here in the front. Turn the palms up, inhale, you're taking this big A shape. Exhale, back into your warrior two. Inhale, take it back up, hold it here, left hand to the hips. Start to extend back, reverse triangle. Feel this opening onto the right side. Again, if this feels too much, the arm can always be bent. Exhale, bend into the knees. Let the right hand stay on the thigh or the forearm. Roll that shoulder back. Feel this opening into the heart. Maybe you sink a little deeper. The connections from the left heel to the fingertips, and maybe the fingertips will start to reach up and over. Extended side angle. as you exhale, slowly gaze down, take that left hand back, and inhale, bring yourself up. Warrior two, we're gonna extend the front leg and perhaps your heel toe your foot a little closer in. You're gonna locate your block and bring it a little closer in. So again, the hand can be on the thigh, but it's much nicer if you have the hand on the block so there's no pressure on your thigh, and you roll your shoulder back. Feel the opening of the heart. And if everything is working, you can even take that left arm and open up. Uttita Trikonasana, extended triangle. With your next exhale, gaze down, soften into the knee a little bit so you can take that back heel off the floor. Find your blocks, and we're coming into pyramid. So now the stretch is gonna be the back of your right hamstring. So push your right leg back. Lengthen from the crown of the head to the tail, and then start to find a little bit more ease. You can drop the height of the blocks if you don't need it. You can even let your upper body fold over that leg, and that's definitely gonna feel a little deeper. So if you need less, stay a little bit higher up. With your next exhale, soften into that right knee. We're coming into a balance pose here. We're gonna transition into a warrior three. Have the blocks in front of you. Pick up that back heel, and maybe it just slides. Maybe that's it. But maybe you can find a little bit more lift from the crown of the head to the heel, core engage, hips engage here, and feel this opening in the heart. The gaze is to the floor slightly ahead of you, and then with the exhale, you soften, the feet come parallel. You come into that little bit of a chair, reach the arms forward, and then it comes up. Beautiful. Exhale, hands to your heart. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. I'm just gonna move the blocks to the other side so that I don't turn my back to you. You stay exactly where you are. So from here, grounding to the feet, start to find that connection, core engaged, shoulders relax. Inhale, let your arms reach up, lift up, Urdhva Hastasana. As you exhale, soften through your knees, ground, and you start to take your fingertips to your blocks, stepping the right foot back. Drop the right heel, and inhale, let your arms open up. Warrior one. As you exhale, we're gonna fidget that back foot to warrior two. So it's a little different, it's a little bit more open and wider. The arms go strong and long. Turn the palms up, inhale. Coming up. And exhale, bending left knee and ankle are aligned. Inhale, perhaps take it up. Take that right hand to the hips, open it up, reverse. And again, if reaching up is too much, you can always bend the arm. With your next exhale, you're gonna come back. We're coming into extended side angle. So the left hand can come to the thigh, the forearm, and you start to go a little deeper with that knee. The extension goes from the right heel to the fingertips as you open the heart. Take a nice deep breath there. And with your next exhale, gazing down, let the right hand pull you back. You're in your warrior two. And as you exhale, we're gonna come into triangle. Hinging that hip, start to walk that foot a little closer in. Find a block for your support. As you push your left hip back, you take your hands to your hips and you roll and you open your chest. So trying to find a little bit more opening into the chest here. Sorry about that. And then maybe that arm will go up. So pushing down to lift up. Beautiful. With your next exhale, perhaps looking down, softening the knee, let that arm come down and looking for your other block. Take the back heel off the floor. So now you're finding your two blocks. Lengthen from the crown of the head, press your left hip back. So now pyramid, you're gonna get into the back of your left leg. From the crown of the head to your tail, you're stretching. And with your next exhale, maybe you start to soften. So that means that maybe you don't need the blocks too high. You can might be able to let it go, or even softening the upper body over the leg. Take one more breath in. And with your next exhale, soften it out. Soften the knees, bend. And we're gonna take those blocks a little further ahead. So this is your version of warrior three. We're gonna keep the hands on the blocks. We're gonna lift that right leg up as much as possible. So perhaps that right leg is down, but if you can feel that you're pressing through that leg and the crown of the head, the chest moving forward, you might feel a little bit more engagement. And as you exhale, feet are parallel. Slowly inhale, take the arms up. And exhale, hands to the heart. So we're coming out to our last part. We're coming into our balance pose. So grab your block. And we're working with eagle. So we did those arms in the beginning. We're gonna put it together with the legs. I know eagle is a little harder to do. It's a little more core engagement, more leg engagement. But again, if you prefer, to do chair or tree pose, feel free to do tree pose, all right? Or some other balance that you would like to do. So soften a little bit into the knees. So think about buoyancy in the knees. So your knees have to be bent. It's like you're doing your chair pose. So from the side, remember when we do the chair, the sit bone's going back, the weight is on the heels to protect the knees. It's the same thing. The only difference is that I'm gonna cross my outer leg. So I'm gonna mirror you. My left leg is gonna be closer to the block. My right, your right leg is gonna be coming up and over, and you're gonna sink back. So think again, the legs pull and squeeze together. When you do that, feel that your core engages. The tail drops from the side. It's the same thing, right? You're doing that work. And now you're gonna take your wings out. So you have your right leg on top, you're gonna bring your right arm on the bottom. Give yourselves a hug. Again, you deserve it. Inhale, take your elbows up. Backs of the hands, maybe the front. Inhale, reach up, lift up. Maybe you're nested even a little deeper. Beautiful work. Press, inhale, reach up. Now as you exhale, unwind your arms, but keep the legs the way they are. Pinky toe side of your feet are closer together. You have that block there. When you lean forward, you're gonna take the block to your hands, and this is a cross-legged forward fold. That means you're gonna feel the stretch on the outside of your leg a little bit more. I'm just gonna turn it to the side so you can see one leg is crossed and you're holding onto the block. Stay with the block higher, right? You're keeping the heels on the floor. After you're here for a little bit, you might notice that you might be able to take the block lower or even all the way out. There's no hurry for that. We're gonna exhale and round and come back up, uncross the legs, bring yourself up, and roll the shoulders back. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Move the block, buoyancy on those knees. Get strong onto your heels. Sit back, engage the core. Left leg crosses on top. Hands onto the thighs and sit back. I call this the proper chair. Your chest is up, you're sitting down, you're feeling very proper here. Inhale, let your arms open up, swing your wings, and now your left is gonna come under the right. You're gonna hold it, give yourself a hug once again. Reach your elbows up, backs of the hands, front of the hands, wherever you have there, lift up. Hands away from the face. Perhaps you even nest a little deeper into that eagle Garudasana. And then from here, we're gonna unwind those arms, extend. Now let your right pinky toes, or left, whatever leg is in front, come down, open the arms. And perhaps on the way down, when you find the block, grab that block, take it a little bit higher, support, and let your head relax. Start to soften into the shoulders, maybe seeing the world upside down. Breathe in. And with your next exhale, uncross your legs and let your body roll all the way up. Beautiful work. So this is our final stretch. We're coming down to the mat. If you don't need the blocks to use for your support, you can also skip your flow if you like. Inhale, arms reach up, lift up. Exhale, hands you from the hips, hands to the floor or to the blocks as you step one knee back and then the other. And then moving down through your hips as you find your seat. All right, so from here, letting the legs extend. Perhaps you have a blanket under your sit bones. We're gonna take the right leg and cross it over. Give it a little bit of a hug as you inhale, lengthen. As you exhale, holding it with your elbow and maybe adding one last twist here. Think about the inhale to lift up and the exhale to revolve. And you relax it out, give it a shake. Let's do the other side, twisting. So we've been working with twists. Give it a hug, feel the lift, inhale. Again, feeling all the great digestion energizing that you're gonna feel today. Looking perhaps over that shoulder if you wanna take it a little deeper. And soften and let it go. Extend the legs once again. Keeping the knees really bent here, maybe moving the sit bone. Sometimes it feels really nice to sit on a blanket or even put a blanket under the knees. You're just gonna do a little forward fold. So again, if you have a strap, you can use a strap, but don't think about you need to take it all the way down. You can hold the strap close by and you can just lean your body over it. And perhaps with time you start to extend the legs and you just fold a little bit more. We're gonna come all the way up wherever you are, making sure you have space behind you. And again, that block might come in handy for one last pose. All right, so we're gonna roll down. So just make sure you have the block close by. And as you roll down, bring your knees into your chest. Maybe give it one last rock here, side to side. And letting the left foot come down, the right ankle over the left thigh. And you're gonna bring the hands between the legs into your figure four. Getting a nice stretch into your glutes. Let it rock side to side. If you need a strap between to hold it, you can always do that as well. As you exhale, release, let your left heel come down. Slide your right knee on top of heels, pushing down so your hips move to the right. Your knees drop to the left. And then you open your right shoulder out. You might look over your right side. Breathe here. And with your next exhale, head to the center, knees to the center, uncross your legs. Give both knees a hug and a gentle rock. And we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Cross your left ankle over your right thigh. Thread your hands between, or your strap between the legs under the right thigh. And again, if this bothers your knee and your hips, just keep that foot a little further out or even down on the floor. Again, this side might feel very different. With time, the more parallel that shin comes to your chest, the more you're gonna feel it. With your next exhale, release. Drop your right heel, scooch it, and move the hips to the left, and then you let your knees drop to the right. Perhaps your left shoulder open to the side, and you get this really nice opening through the side body, the armpit, the ribs. And we come back to the center one last time. Knees into the chest, feet onto the floor, and taking your Viparita Karani, your waterfall pose, just to restore it, to release it. Bring the block under your sit bones, you bridge your hips. Elbows dig in to open the chest. Keep that opening in your chest and then let your legs just float. And the idea is floating. You want to feel that buoyancy, that softness in the knees, that the legs float over the hips. And you just start to unwind. So all those twists were really energizing, uplifting. So this is a really nice way to balance it out, calming it down. Perhaps even start to let your eyes close. And with your next exhale, let it go. Feet comes down to the floor, block slides from under. And just giving your knees one big hug, holding the backs of the knees or the blades of your feet if you have the flexibility for happy baby. A little rocking side to side before we let the legs move forward. It might feel good to bring the blocks under the knees or a blanket under the knees. Let the arms release to the side. Soften it out completely. The eyes get heavy in the sockets. The cheeks and jaw relaxes. The tongue floats in your mouth. Feel the room and the broadness of the mouth, the softness moving down to the back of the throat, down your shoulders, your arms, your fingers. The spine is relaxed, the hips are heavy. As you continue to release down the legs, the knees, all the way to your toes. If you're happy where you are, stay where you are. If you feel like moving, start to wiggle the fingers and the toes, the wrists, the ankles. Take your time. Deepening the breath. Just feeling for the echo of your practice, how the mind and the body feels. Deepening the breath, you notice that arms start to reach back and this nice big body stretch with the inhale. And with the exhale, perhaps letting the knees come into the chest, give it a hug and a rock. And rolling to any side that feels more comfortable for you. Use your hands to come up to your seat. And allowing the eyes to remain closed and the spine be nice and tall, with the head resting over the heart and the heart resting over the hips. Allow the right and the left hand to come over your heart center. And you feel, once again, the rising and fall of the breath, the warmth of the body, the light, the gratitude you brought into your practice, and carrying it with you, we bow the head to the heart, surrendering the mind to the divine in the heart. Let your heart guide you. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me this afternoon as this beautiful Boston Gardens here. If you have any questions, doubts, you can always shoot me an email. Thank you so much. Be well.